luxury mansion in a silver limousine. She'd sent out invitations and everything. Her name, written twice, with Anne in the middle, the calligraphy of coupling. She strode down the aisle to At Last by Etta James, faced the celebrant like a keen soldier reporting for duty, her voice shaky, yet sure. I do. I do. You may now kiss the mirror. Applause, confetti, every single one of the 140 guests deem the service unimprovable, especially the vows. So, from the heart, not a soul questioned their devotion. You only had to look at them, hand, cupped in hand, smiling out of the same eyes. You could sense their secret language, bone deep, blended blood. Toasts were frequent, tearful. One guest eyed his wife, hovering harmlessly at the bar, and imagined what his life might have been if he'd responded years ago to that offer in his head. I'm the only one who will ever truly understand you. Marry me, Derek. I love you. Marry me. At the time, he hadn't taken his proposal seriously. He recharged his champagne flute, watched the newlywed cut her five-tiered cake, both hands on the knife. Is it too late for us to try? Derek whispered to no one as the bride glided herself onto the dance floor, taking turns first to lead.